So I know my last video on analog data kind of maybe left you a little bit confused, but we'll try and clear that up as we go along and we talk about analog write and analog read. So today I'm going to talk about analog write. And what analog write allows us to do is take an LED and rather than show it at full brightness, which is what we get with digital write, we can actually show it at half brightness. Now, when we talked a little bit about analog data, we talked about how we might have a graph of voltage versus time. And when we talk about digital data, we're talking about 5 volts. So out of our Arduino, we can get all on, or we can be all off. But I can't be anywhere in between, all right? And what we really want to be able to do is we want to be able to say, you know what? That's way too bright. That's way too bright. So rather than being all on, I want to be only partially on. I want to be on maybe 75%. Okay, that might be more like two-thirds. So we'll call this 66%. I want to be 66% on rather than all the way on. Or maybe I want to start and I want to be off and I want to slowly over time fade up to full brightness. Maybe I want to do something like that. But I can't do that with a digital write. And this is where analog write comes in. What analog write allows us to do is it takes it from either on and off, either on and off, and allows us to do this. We can have any level between 0 and 5 volts. Now, it does this in a weird way. So if I start changing the voltage that I supply to my LED, then it's going to change the amount of current that the LED pulls. And I know you're like, yeah, and? So what that's going to do is it's going to do two things to the LED. One, it's going to change its efficiency, so it's not as efficient at turning electricity into light. It's going to decrease that efficiency. And then two, it may also change the wavelength of light slightly that the LED is producing. And when I talk about the wavelength of light, what I'm really talking about is the color. So by changing the voltage supply from my Arduino to my LED, I might actually change the color of the LED slightly, as well as lower its efficiency in turning electricity into visible light. So engineers, smart people out there, have figured out a better way to do it. So the way LEDs work, LEDs are semiconductors, and they're looking for a specific voltage and current. And when they get that, they emit photons of light. And so what we can do, though, with an analog write is we can do something called pulse width modulation. And we can then use this pulse width modulation to fade the LEDs. Now, how does this work? Well, first off, I want to say one thing. If all you really need to know is that if we use the command analog write's going to look for two arguments. The first argument is the pin number, and the second is the brightness. And this is going to be a number also. So this is our pin, as it says, and this brightness can be anywhere from 0 to 255. We'll talk about why this weird number of 0 to 255 in a later video. But for now, if you wanted to light up an LED on pin 3 at say, oh, I don't know, half brightness, I would write this command. I would write analog write three comma 125, or actually 128, why not? And that would be approximately, it'd be right around half brightness. Okay, if I wanted full brightness, I would write 3 comma 255. If I wanted the LED to be completely off, I would write 3 comma 0. All right, not so bad. One thing to know is that this will overflow. So in programming sense, what overflow means is I can do a number from zero along this long number line, tick, 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 all the way to 255. If I add one more to it and it becomes 256, the Arduino will see 256 as zero. So 256 is viewed as if it's zero. And 257 is viewed as if it is one, right? Not so bad. So keep that in mind. If your project behaves very badly, it might be because you are writing a number bigger than 255, all right? So that's all you need to know about analog write. Oh, wait, I lied. One last thing you need to know about analog write is not all pins can do analog write. On your Arduino, you're gonna look at the pins. So you've got digital pins that are numbered 0 through 13, yeah? Look at your board, and you'll notice that some of those pins are labeled one of two ways, depending on which flavor of Arduino board you happen to have. They're either gonna have a PWM, which stands for pulse width modulation, next to the pin, or they're gonna have a little squiggle indicating analog. Because remember, digital is solid up, solid down, where analog can be a nice continuous wave, like a sine wave. It can be an analog wave. So on your Arduino, you're gonna have six pins on a standard Arduino that are labeled either PWM or have a little squiggle next to them, all right? Those are the only pins that the analog write command will work with. Very important. So if you try to do a digital write on pin one, I'm sorry, if you try to do an analog write on pin one, it's not gonna work because pin one doesn't have a squiggle next to it, all right? So you've gotta look for the ones that are labeled PWM or some our red boards have the little squiggle next to them. All right, now that right there is all you really need to know. So you can stop the video right now and you will still know everything you need to know for this course. But I wanted to continue a little bit just so I can talk about what pulse width modulation is and how engineers, those smart guys and women, have figured out how to make it so that we can fade LEDs and still have peak efficiency. All right? So if you want that, continue. If not, stop now. I'm assuming you want that, so let's talk about it. So again, what I might want, if I do voltage versus time, graph again, what I might want is, and here's my 5 volts coming out of my pin, I might want my LED to be on at this level, which would correspond to, oh, I don't know, 2.5 volts. But how do I do that? Because I can't just put 2.5 volts out of my pin. Actually, that's not 2.5 volts, is it? Let's call it 1.5 volts. But I can't just put 1.5 volts out of my pin. So what do I do instead? I can only put 5 volts out of my pins. So what I do instead is I do something called pulse width modulation. And what the heck does that mean? So let's say I'm going to tick off marks here. These ticks represent what we call the duty cycle. And that's how long one cycle lasts. So what we're gonna do with pulse width modulation is we're going to have a series of repeating cycles, all right? A series of repeating cycles. And that cycle, we call it a duty cycle. It's a certain amount of time. So if I, and again, we're always gonna be on all the way at 5 volts. So if I turn my LED on at 5 volts for half my duty cycle, and then I turn it off for the other half of my duty cycle, and then turn it on for the next half of my duty cycle, and then off, and then on, and then off, as long as it's only half the duty cycle, this equals 50% brightness. That'll be 50% brightness. All right, not so bad. So if I wanted to be full bright, I would have it on for the entire duty cycle. If I wanted it to be 1/4 bright, I would have it on for 1/4 of the duty cycle. So if I wanted it to be dimmer, I'm gonna create my same axes. I'm gonna have the same duty cycle. And when I talk about this duty cycle, I'm talking about this duty cycle is milliseconds in length, okay? This duty cycle is milliseconds in length. I don't know how many milliseconds in length it is for the Arduino, but it's small, okay? It's very, it's flashing very fast. It's flashing so fast, you're not gonna see it with your naked eye. However, if you take your iPhone, which can record high-speed video, and you record it, you can probably slow it down frame by frame, and you can probably actually see it flashing. So if I wanted the light to be dimmer, I would just have it on for less time. But the duty cycle is the same. So the amount of time that it's off is longer compared to the amount of time that it's on. Something like this. And if I want it to be brighter. So the cool thing is, so this might be something like 25% brightness. All right, not so bad. So we can, by changing that length of time on versus off, we can make it brighter or dimmer, up to its full brightness or down to all the way off. And that's how pulse width modulation works on any modern electronics. So again, if it's got an LED and you're changing brightness, in all likelihood, it's using some sort of pulse width modulation. It's flashing the LED. So the LED is always being turned on at full power and then being turned off and then turned on again at full power and then turned off. And the amount of time versus on versus off will tell you how bright the LED is. Not so bad, right? But again, for this course, you don't really need to know what pulse width modulation means. You just need to know that those are the only pins you can use for analog write.